We're going to stick with the focus on Capitol Hill now, where a top health official turned whistleblower will testify to Congress this morning. Rick Bright claims that he was fired from a key job overseeing development of a coronavirus vaccine for purely political reasons, and he's expected to issue a stark warning about the spread of the virus. Our senior congressional correspondent Mary Bruce has the details. Good morning, Mary.
Good morning, George. Well, Rick Bright is sounding the alarm on Capitol Hill this morning. In testimony, the ousted vaccine expert will warn lawmakers that, quote, our window of opportunity is closing. He will say, if we fail to develop a national coordinated response based in science, I fear the pandemic will get far worse and be prolonged, causing unprecedented illness and fatalities. Bright will say that without decisive action, quote, 2020 will be the darkest winter in modern history. Now, Bright has filed that whistleblower complaint alleging that he was removed from his position for raising concerns about the administration's response and for cautioning against the use of unproven treatments, which the president was promoting. President Trump, though, has dismissed Bright's complaint, calling him a, quote, disgruntled employee.
And George. Mary, meantime, also on Capitol Hill, the FBI is stepping up its investigation of a senator who appeared to make stock sales tied to the COVID crisis.
Yeah, the Justice Department appears to be ramping up this investigation of Republican Senator Richard Burr. Overnight, federal agents reportedly served Burr with a warrant and seized his cell phone. Burr, of course, raised suspicions about whether or not he used privileged information for his own personal financial gain when he sold off as much as $1.7 million in stocks in hard-hit companies just as this crisis was beginning and just as he was receiving briefings on the impacts of the virus. George, we have reached out to the senator this morning. He is not commenting. The FBI and Justice Department are also not commenting today. George.
Mary Bruce, thanks very much. Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.